Hi guys, so I am Anand Shankar, and today my talk is Node.js. So Node.js means, so that is not any technology Node.js. So Node.js means I don't want to use JavaScript. So that is the meaning of Node.js. So why I don't want to use JavaScript? Because I want to use Dart. So what is Dart? And so actually Dart is promoted and created by the Google. So what is the advantage of Dart over the JavaScript? So all these things, so in brief, we will discuss here. Okay, so the first question is, what is Dart? Okay, so the simple, because if it is replacing the JavaScript, so it means simply it will be the for the web application development tool only. So that is the programming language only, and that is in open source so that is developed by the Google. And so the first, so it was initiated in the GoTo conference in October 2011. So it's not very old language, so it is very new, and so still it could not get the market as the JavaScript has. So, but slowly they are trying to achieve. And so there are some advantages, so that means JavaScript doesn't have, and that Dart is having. So what are these? So we'll see here. Okay, so the goal is the Dart. Actually, so if you see this time, so JavaScript is a simply, you can say, the lingua franca. So that is the word you can say for the web development, so that we use. So suppose we are developing any web application, so for the validation, so simply use the JavaScript only for any kind of validation. And that is not only, so because this time, as you see, people are moving not only on web, so they are also moving on the mobile. So JavaScript is very good for the mobile compatibility also, very good of the JavaScript. So that is the major advantage of the JavaScript. And the HTML5, so the compatibility with the HTML5, so that's also important factor here. Okay, so Dart is class-based object-oriented language. So that I have mentioned here. So anybody can tell JavaScript is object-oriented, or what kind of language it is?
Object-based.
Object-based.
Prototype-based.
Okay, so the language will come under the object oriented when it follows some, there are some standards if that follows, means that is the having the concept of the classes and objects, something like that, and the inheritance features and something like that. So if that language follows, so we put under the object oriented. Okay, so JavaScript also has that, all the things, and it follows the all the features of the object oriented. So you can put that under the object oriented also. If somebody told like that, we can put under the object oriented. Okay, but this is purely object oriented, you can say the Dart, because in the JavaScript, if you want to achieve the object orientation feature, so you have to do the lot of other things. So that is the not very familiar to the programmer who are already using the C++ or Java or any C# languages. So this time, Java and C++ and C#, so these are the very popular languages. So people are trying to go in that field only, and they don't want to learn another kind of the programming languages and the syntaxes and all the things. So that is the very familiar with that. Okay, and other things like that lexical scoping and the closure, so all these things also supported by the Dart. And the most important thing here I have mentioned optional static typing, so that's also supported by the Dart. Okay, so when it was asked to the Google, so why you are you people are trying to promote this Dart, and why you developed, what is the idea behind it? So the engineers in the Google, so they have replied this statement. So you can see what they are trying to say. As you see, lot of the Google like applications, Gmail, Google Plus, and Google Docs, and so lots of applications they have given. So they are very much familiar with the what are the challenges are in this field. So, and even if you see, so they are also writing the version 8 of the JavaScript engine. Still they are introducing this Dart. So definitely there will be some challenge so that they are facing. So the, what is the main challenge? Actually, when you write a huge code for the JavaScript, and if you have observed that the loading time of the JavaScript code, so how it is high, so you are knowing better if you are using the JavaScript. So that is the main problem. So that we can say like the concurrency problem. So that's there with the JavaScript. So that slightly it is removed in the Dart. So if you are using the Dart, so first thing, so your programming structure writing the way of the programming will be very simple, like the simple C++ and Java you are using. Another advantage will be you can manage your program. So if you are writing a large program, so JavaScript, if you want to achieve the inheritance simply in the JavaScript, so it is very complex to achieve that. But because Dart supports the class concept, so you can simply inherit that class and you can reuse that. So that reusability is not there much in the JavaScript compared to the Dart. So these are the advantages. Okay, and another thing, so that I mentioned here, so native support. So for a language, so that's also very important factor, the native support. So that's a very strong native support. So that is in Dart. And like I have mentioned here, a very critical issue with the JavaScript is handling concurrency. Dart has isolates. Okay, so the isolates is given in the Dart. So using that, you can easily can handle the concurrency problem. Okay, so now I will show some coding difference, means how you write the code in the JavaScript and in the Dart. So I will not go in the, more deep, but a little overview I will give here, means how you write the code in the Dart and how you start with that. Okay, so first the embedding the code. So suppose you are using the JavaScript, then what you write? So in the your application, so simply you write script and src, so just give the your link of the your JavaScript, and so that is loaded. But here in Dart also, so you write that script tag, and here will be the only instead of the and this is optional, you can type also, you can give here like the JavaScript, but here you have to mention application/Dart, and after that SRC, your Dart SRC you can attach here. And suppose, so the major problem of the Dart is it runs a virtual machine, so that is known as the Dartium. Okay, so that is the you can say that is the little disadvantages of the Dart also. Because you need Dartium environment to run your Dart. But this time is most of the browsers are coming with that, and that is a very small virtual machine you can download and install it. In Windows and Linux and Mac, for all the OS it is available, so you can install it. Yeah, but suppose you are developing a web application, so you are not guaranteed that my client will be using the Dartium. And I can't force everybody to install the Dartium. So in that case, how will I handle? So for that, there is a solution. Just you add this line in your code. So what will happen? So it will check if Dartium is available in his machine. So it will load this code otherwise if it is not available, so automatically it will start the RTM engine from the server and it will convert to the JavaScript, and JavaScript version will be loaded automatically. So you not need to worry, means how will I handle that, means RTM things and all this stuff. Okay, so just you have to add this line. Okay, so there is a one file, so dart.js, so that is given by the dart only, so just you put in packages and under the browser, and automatically it will be loaded and it will be converted to the JavaScript. Okay, so the entry point. So suppose if you want to start your program, so how you start in JavaScript? Do you have any entry point? No, there is no entry point. Means from where you want to start, you can start. So manually you have to call that method. You can create a main method also in JavaScript also, but you have to manually call that. But here there is an entry point. So that method name is main. So where main will be found, so your entry point will be there only. So from there you can start. And you can not only the write for the web, you can write the program using the Dart on console-based program also. Console-based, and for the mobile applications also you can write, and web applications already it is there. Okay, so first I will show you how you will write, and actually for if you want to write the Dart program, so they have the people already have given there is an editor, Dart editor. So if you want to use that editor, then you can use. Otherwise, there is a plugin is already available for the Eclipse also. So you can install the plugin in your Eclipse, and you can write your code in Eclipse itself. Okay. So a little introduction. So just I will. So here, suppose I have started this Eclipse. Okay. So just if you want to install your plugin, so just you go in. Install new software, and the URL is already given on the Google site or Dart site. So just you take that from there, and you can install it easily. Okay, so already I have installed the Dart plugin here. So just suppose I want to create a Dart project. So just simply I will go on. And Dart. So this is a Dart file and Dart project. So what do you want to create? Suppose I want to create a Dart project here. Okay, so some name I have given here, and just finish it. Okay, so your main method already has been created here. Okay, so simply you can run your program. So I want to run on Dart command line, so just okay. So your result came here. So simply like you can write your program here. Okay. So the print method, so that I was using, so that was the used in the to print on the console. But suppose if I want to show any message on the web, then how will I write? So suppose for the simple example, so window.alert, so just I put there. So but for that you have to import something. So that is the dot HTML. So this thing you have to import if you want any HTML features. So this is a library, so inbuilt library. So you have to import, like in Java and other languages you import. So but if I run it here, so it will not run. Why? Because I am printing this on command prompt, so it will not print. So it will run on the web only. So just I will show you when you create your web application, then how you will use there. So simple a web application I will create, and I will put that file there, and I will show miss how you will use that. So suppose I am creating a simple Java project. Okay, so like my this is the program, so that is written in Java, in Dart. So that is the Dart test one dot Dart. And suppose I want put in my web application. Suppose I don't want Dart, but I have written all the programs in the Dart only, and I want put in the JavaScript. Then what I will do? So I not need to put the manually. So just simply right click here. Dart and generate JavaScript. Okay, so one file will be generated here. That is the my file name and .js. So just you can copy this file and you can paste in your web application. And src, so simply just you give the name of this file. And just build your program. Okay. So like this, so simply I can write in the Dart. And if I don't want to use the Dart, or if DartEM is not available, so manually also you can do, or automatically. So just what I showed that line. So just you add that line in your web application, and automatically it will be converted to the Dart, that JavaScript. So like this you can write your program. Okay, so now we'll see some other things. Okay, so like this is the code modularity, how you can achieve that here in the Dart. So there is no native implementation in the JavaScript, as you know. And here simply suppose if you created any Dart file, and so just you want use that as a library, so you can use as a library also. So if you want to create a library, so simply put this library keyword, and after that give your that library name and whatever the classes and everything you want. So just you can write there, and when you want use, so just import and your that library name. So it will be imported. So you can reuse the code here. You mention in your other functions, you can mention the return type also. And if you don't want, then by default, so that will be the where type will be the return. Okay. And suppose if you are passing anything, and suppose I here taking this three parameters and passing only one, so what will be the result come? Undefined. Okay, so that is the major headache of the JavaScript, because normally all the languages having the concept of the null. So that is a very familiar and very easy to check that. Suppose anything happens, so if you want to check if the value is coming or not. So but the checking in the undefined, because so that is treated as a string only, so it is very difficult to check that. So but here in the Dart, so it will return null, or if such type of situation will happen, so already exceptions are defined here, so it will throw the exception. So it will be very easy to handle that exception and know what is the problem in the your program. But in the debugging in the JavaScript, as you know, so it is a very, very, very difficult task. Okay, and some other features like the for each. So this is also not available with the JavaScript, and you can use. So that is a very programming things. And classes. Suppose if you want to create a class in JavaScript, then how you do? So this is the way to create the class in JavaScript. So that will be the function only, but it will be treated as a class, because you can handle it as an object. So it will be treated as a class also. But there is no particular keyword to define that class. But in the Dart, so that is there, class, simple, you write your class name, and in between, so you can misdefine your functions, or you can misuse the closures also. So it's up to you. Constructor, suppose if you want to see the constructor, so you can't see in the JavaScript how you will write. So it will be there, but like this, in other languages you are writing the constructors simply with the class name, you can write define your constructor also. Suppose for the simple things, so I want to achieve the inheritance, then how you will do? So these are lots of the code to do the inheritance for the JavaScript. And finally, a simple inheritance, if I want to do, so lots of the code I have to write. But if you see in the Dart, so simply, just you give the name, like class name, I have given the person, and after that, next, if you want to inherit, so suppose I created any employee class, so just extend keyword is there, so using that you can inherit simply. Like the advanced for loop also is available here, like in the other languages are giving C sharp and C++, so that is also available here. So for the iterating, so it is means manually you iterate there, but here if you know that type, so simply you can just put this like the advanced for loop, and you can iterate your any things. Okay, and DOM manipulation. Suppose if you want to manipulate the DOM, then what you do? So simply we write like document.createElement, and after that inner HTML, and inner HTML you go, and whatever you want to manipulate, so you manipulate from there. But here what you will do? Simply we create the new, so there is a new keyword, and element.html, and directly you can manipulate your DOM. exception handling as there is not predefined exceptions in the your much predefined exception in your JavaScript, and the main headache is suppose if you miss any exception will be thrown. So always you have to check that. So this is the instance of this error, then you have to manually handle. But here, so already the try and catches are given. So simply you can use the try catches and you can handle your exceptions here. Okay, and Ajax. So that is the major advantage here. So suppose if you want to make any Ajax call, then what you will do? So you will write this type of code in the JavaScript. And then finally you will get the result and you will process on the your response. But here if you see in the Dart, simply one line. Just HTTP request dot request and just you pass your JSON object, that's all. Then and you get your data. Okay. So the next is the .con. So actually what is the .con? So actually see, .con is meaning the Dart converter. So that is used to convert the JavaScript to Dart and Dart to JavaScript. So the if you want to work on that, so that's I think not clearly visible. So github.com, so it is given the reference here. So anyways, I will upload this slide that Barcamp site, so you can get the reference from there. So just you can go there and you can find that .con, and if you want to convert JavaScript to Dart and Dart to JavaScript, so that converter is already available, so you can use that. Or in the Eclipse also it is available, but the Eclipse only will translate Dart to JavaScript, not JavaScript to Dart, and Dart editor also supports only the Dart to JavaScript only. It can't convert the JavaScript to Dart. Okay, so now we'll see some demo. Definitely you will be interested to know if anybody is using this Dart or not, and so. Yeah, lots of people are using, but in the couple of projects so where we are working, so means we are using. So that first is the altermediguide.com. So that is the in medical the guide website. So in that Dart is using, and that is the OpenE startup. So here also Dart is used, and next is the ekisan.com. So here also we use that Dart. Okay, so now in the web development. So web development, how you can use that Dart? And apart from this, suppose that JavaScript is very popular in the gaming also. So suppose if you want to create the game, and because your game should run on the browsers, today's most of the smartphones and mobiles are supporting the browsers, so they are very much comfortable. So can we create your games in Dart also? So yes, you can create, and I will show some interesting demo also. How the people has created that demos. So simply for first demo, so simply I will show you. So this is a barcode generator. So if you want to generate any barcode, so that is written in the Dart only. Okay, so you work on the JavaScript, so simply you can work here also, you can call the Ajax, and so this type of stuff you can do here. So okay, so this is your first one demo of that. Okay, so some guys has created this type of stuff in the Dart, so you can look up that. Okay, so this if you want to write your program for the 3D, so that's also possible in the Dart. So you can use the 3D or 2D, whatever you want. So you can use your logics and here also. So in Dart also all these things are possible. Is what you can do in JavaScript. Okay, so these are like some games are so created in the Java that Dart only. So you can use that. And if you want, then you can play also. You can kill the Java and JS. Okay, so this is the Dart, and Dart is firing, and you can kill your JS. So you can play this game. So just the purpose is to show how the things are moving in the Dart. So if you want to animate anything, see like how Dart is capable to do all these things. Okay, so this type of animations are created using the Dart. Okay, so you can play this type of games in the Dart. And suppose if you want to code, if you want that code, so code is also available and how it is created. So this is the HTML part of that. So simply here we are using the canvas, HTML5 canvas only. And on the canvas, so just we are playing here. And if you want that code, so just go on this link. And on the GitHub, so all the code is given. So just you can download if you want, or if you want to work with this game, then you can fork it and you can work on it. Okay. So for all the whatever things I showed here, so you can get the source code up also on the GitHub. So just go on dart-lang.github.com and here you will get lots of stuff like this, and so with the source code. Okay, so the references, so I have given here from where I taken this to use that slide to create that slide. So from the dotlang.org and there is the O'Reilly publication. So a book is published from the O'Reilly. So I have taken some of the content from there also. So if you want to study that book, so that book is also available freely in the dotlang. O'Reilly publication, so they published, but ebook they have given the free only. So you can download that book from here. The URL is out here. dart-lang.github.com. So if you go here, so one corner will be there for the ebook. So there you can get the original O'Reilly book also for the Dart. Okay, so any question, please. If you have any question or any doubt, so you can ask.
What's the big deal of using Dart?
Yeah, so the
Dart code is pretty dirty.
Sorry?
The Dart code.
So actually not it is because the managing the code in the JavaScript, so if you are writing a simple program, so that's fine. Okay, but if you are managing a very large program like Yahoo people are doing experiment lots upon that, because most of the in the site they are using the JavaScript only. So when you load that JavaScript in the browser, so browser is not having the much memory and much spaces to load all the JavaScript and having all the at runtime. And as you know, the JavaScript is always that load in the client side only, in the browser only. So means the managing that thing is very, very challenging. This time that is very challenging, because if you put all the all the things, so just simply if you run any website on and just start the Firebug and see how much code is attached of the JavaScript with that. So that should not happen, because suppose if you want to use only one script, but you have to you load all the files together, and all the files will be stored in your browser only. So that decrease the performance of your website. But in the here you can manage, because here modularity are there. So you can create the different classes, and whatever the required, so just you load that class, not need to load the whole file. And suppose if you are, and because as I told modularity, because the suppose if simply if you want to inherit, and how you create JavaScript, so simply you create any file, something .js, and you put all the functions there, or not one file, so let's say 10 files or 20 files you created, but not for the every class you will not create different files. I think in one file everybody put lots of the functions. So and all the file will be loaded together. You can't load one function. But here for the one class you create a separate file and load only the which is required. So that is the major advantage of the modularity in the Dart. So that is not in the your JavaScript. So that's why the Google people are promoting this, because they are facing, because even I mentioned, they already wrote that version 8 of the JavaScript engine. Still they are promoting this language. And this time, so I can say, if you go on the Dart website, so they are very active, and very actively they are contributing. So lots of mails and lots of updates you will get daily. So I can't say today or in the 1 year or 2 year may will take to come in the market this Dart. But let's see what happens. So this was my opinion, because what I saw, so that was the better than the JavaScript.
Like we know that JavaScript we can't debug it, so Dart can debug.
Yeah, so that is the major advantage of that also, because the debugging, that is a very crucial in the, you can say that's in the JavaScript. So suppose if you find any error, so no exception will be thrown, and you will not understand where is the problem. So until you are not opening your Firebug, and there is no IDE for that where you can debug your code. But that is a very good support of the Dart in that. Because the IDE at least fully support that for the JavaScript code writing, so you can use that debug. So you can use that, and still Firebug is always with you for Dart also. So you can work with Dart also. If you want to debug the Firebug, you can do.
Is there an option to connect DBs and DBs using the?
Yes. Like in JavaScript, you connect simply here also. Actually, all the things what is the supported by the JavaScript, either Ajax call, so suppose, or if you want to load your jQuery, and everything is supported by the Dart, because the same replica they have likely given. So if you compare, if you go on the Dart website, so there you will see so that is exactly whatever the given by the JavaScript in the simple form they have given in the Dart, because they are very well experienced with the JavaScript Google people. So they know what is the inside and what is the complexities are there. So keeping on in all the minds, so they are developing this language. So whatever the disadvantages of the JavaScript, so they are removing and try to remove in the Dart.
So is Dart built on top of JavaScript?
No. So there is not. That is a completely independent language.
Okay. So do you foresee it as a general purpose language going forward, or is it only for the web?
No, so it is, you can develop for the web also, and your console based programming, it is general purpose, you can say.
So does it also have the concept of virtual machine?
Yeah, virtual machine, so that I mentioned, that is the DATium. So that is the dependency this time, so that runs under the DATium only. and so that you have to install. And but the main thing, suppose if you are loading your Dart in the your MissBeam application, so that time, so that code will be loaded in the browser. So if your client is not having that Dartium, so it will not run there. But there is a solution. So just I showed one line. So just you one add one line in the your web application. So it will check first. So Dartium is available or not in the client machine. If it is available, then it will be loaded normally. But if it is not available, then what it will do? It will dynamically it will convert all the Dart code in the JavaScript and will be loaded there.
Do you see Dart as the computer for Node.js?
Yeah. So that also means you can check. So in the site, somebody blog also has written for the Node.js. So everything is coming with the Dart. It's whatever the supported by the JavaScript. So slowly everything is coming there.
Yeah. For example, the JIT, you know, a lot of effort has gone in JavaScript to come up with a good just-in-time compiler. Right? Mm-hmm. So do you think that, you know, that the Dart is designed from ground up to be efficient just-in-time compiler, or do you pre-compile something? So what is the kind of support you have?
No,
in a better performance?
So that is a pre-compiled only.
Pre-compiled?
Yeah.
So
because of whenever you write that program, so at the time is when we are building the compiling, so it will be pre-compiled and will be interpreted like that.
But they don't have bytecodes, right?
No, so that internally compiled, so they don't give you the bytecode, so that's not.
It's not a public standard.
It is not public, right? So simply the Dart is fine for that. The source code and as well as the bytecode, whatever the we can see, that is the only.
So okay. You said you wrote, you were involved with writing a JavaScript engine. So is that you are part of the development team, or you wrote your own engine? Or
no. So actually, I am part of the that Dart. So I mean, a very small contributor of the Dart.
Okay.
So Java and that JavaScript to Dart converter. So that is I am involved in that. Okay, any questions? Okay, thanks a lot, guys.